My dear brothers and sisters in Christ Jesus, today's readings speaks about the beatitudes, the blessedness, the supreme happiness, the eternal happiness, the eternal reward that we are going to receive there in heaven. The question is, are you listening to the beatitudes of Jesus Christ? We know that the beatitudes are the instructions given to the disciples as well as the crowd to live here in this world in order to achieve the eternal happiness in their life. If we are ready to listen to the beatitudes of God, we are going to receive the eternal happiness in our life. The all readings of today teaches us the importance of that we are the children of God when we share the blessings among the people, among the brothers and sisters, those who are in need. We can experience the real blessedness, the beatitude of God Almighty in our life. What is the happiness that we are receiving here in this world? Jesus is giving a contradictory happiness than that of the world. From the gospel or through the beatitude, Jesus is putting in front of us a different type of supreme happiness in our life. We know the happiness there in the world, the wealth, the health, maybe the influence, or maybe the prestige and power and authority that we are enjoying here in this world will give you the happiness. But Jesus is telling that that is not the permanent happiness. This is something temporary that we are receiving, we are experiencing in our life. Jesus is giving something paradoxical: hunger, thirst, the poor, the rejection, and the hatredness, and also the persecution. When we face all these things in our life, my dear brothers and sisters, we can experience the real eternal happiness in our life. There we have seen, rejoice and leap for joy, Jesus is telling. When you are persecuted, when you are hated, when you are poor, or you are having the starvation in our life, Jesus is telling, rejoice and live for joy. How we can rejoice in the midst of all these persecutions and suffering? The only thing Jesus is providing, those who are trusting in God, those who are listening the word of God, those who are obeying the word of God, really we can experience the eternal blessedness in our life, the eternal happiness in our life. Unless and until if we are not able to trust in God and obey the commandments of the Lord, my dear brothers and sisters, we cannot experience the real happiness in our life. That is what we see there in the first reading. The prophet Jeremiah tells us, blessed are you those who have trust in God and also the trust in the promises of God. You will be like a tree planted nearby the running water, nearby the lake. Otherwise, my dear brothers and sisters, you will be like a barren tree planted there in the desert. If you have the trust in God, really you can produce the fruit in our life. Otherwise it will be a barren tree, that our life. We may be planted in the desert, we will be experiencing the temporary pleasure and fruits in our life. It will not be the eternal thing. That is what Jesus is telling. Because we are always having the trust in the material world, the material things. Listen to the voice of Jesus Christ. Obey the commandments of Jesus Christ. Obey the beatitude in our life and follow the value, the merits of beatitude in our life. We can experience the real happiness in our life. Last week we have seen Simon Peter had a great trust in God. Before that, Jesus was not with him. The fruitless night he experienced in his life. Nothing he caught. But you see, the transformation and the change happened there in the life of Simon Peter when he was trusting totally in his life in God. The abundance of catch of fish we have seen, from nothingness to the fullness of life. We have to have the trust in God. We have to listen to the beatitudes of God. Saint Paul says in the second letter of the Corinthians, the first letter of the Corinthians, the blessedness is not something that we can obtain here in this world. The blessedness that we can obtain only there in heaven. If we are believing the resurrection of Jesus Christ, through the ascension and resurrection of Jesus Christ, if we have the assurance, if we have the faith in the resurrection of Jesus Christ, my dear brothers and sisters, we can have the eternal reward in heaven, because Jesus Christ himself is a model for the same. Through his resurrection and ascension, he has received the eternal blessings from the Almighty God. We have to have the eternal blessings in our lives. We have to follow the commandments, the beatitude. We have to listen to the word of God. There in the gospel we can see Jesus was giving a paradoxical hunger, poverty, persecution and hatred and rejection. Because that is not concerned with the worldly merits or the worldly pleasure. Jesus is saying that when you are poor in your heart, you experience the kingdom of God. When you are weeping here in this world, you will be going to laugh, because the eternal reward is going to give you. You have to have the treasure in heaven, not in earth. My dear brothers and sisters, the gospel readings as well as other readings of today compels us, invites us to have a challenge in our life, to live with the beatitudes of Jesus Christ. To listen to the beatitudes of Jesus Christ. We know that millions of people are under starvation here in this world. Homeless people, powerless people. How they can experience the real blessedness, the happiness, the beatitude of Jesus in their life? My dear brothers and sisters, it is only through our life, when we are sharing our blessings that we have received in our life. Let us reflect our own life. We have received the many abundance of blessings from the Almighty God. Whatever things, the material wealth we have, we received that blessing from God. Until and unless we are not sharing the blessing that you have received from the Almighty to the people, those who are in need, my dear brothers and sisters, you cannot experience the real happiness, the real eternal happiness. Otherwise, you are having the treasure here in this world. That is the temporary pleasure that you are going to enjoy, the temporary happiness that you are enjoying here. Look at the life of Jesus. He came to this world and identified himself with the poor people, with the marginalized, with the downtrodden, and he has taken all the worries. He became one among the poor people. He has taken all the sins in his life, and he surrendered his life. He crucified for our sins. He became ransom for many. That is the life model Jesus is giving us. Look at the life of Mother Teresa of Calcutta, working among the poor people, identified herself among the poor people with the poor people. How she was able to do all these things, how she was getting that courage and also the power to do the work there in the poor people. My dear brothers and sisters, she was seeing the face of Jesus in all those poor people, listening to the word of God, listening to the Beatitudes of Christ. She was living in accordance with the Beatitudes of Christ. My dear brothers and sisters, today's gospel inviting each and every one of us, we have to store our power and our strength not here in this world. It should be there in heaven. We have to listen to the Beatitudes of God, Jesus Christ. That is a commandment, that is an instruction that Jesus is giving each and every one of us to lead a good Christian Catholic life here in this world. All the blessings that we have in our life, that should be shared among the people, those who are in need. Then you can experience the real happiness, the eternal happiness that you can experience here in this world, and also the same reward that you are going to receive there in heaven. May God bless each and every one of you.